To say that all good things must come to an end. Footballers at whatever level are not immune to age, and they all at some stage have to bid farewell to the sport that they loved. This is not a game where results matter, it is simply a final curtain call, or a celebration of a career of one who can proudly say he has enriched the beautiful game, the final whistle, which is indeed final. Venue this which simply adds to the spectacle of the game it stages, one of the most impressive arenas in this part of the world. Players here watched by their family and friends, some celebrity faces amongst the crowd as well. Watching just what you are watching.
Well, I played in a few of these, Peter. A good few, actually, including my own. And whatever the circumstances, whether it be a natural retirement or premature, there's always a mixture of happy and sad about the occasion. And this will be no different. Recognition for a good, solid career and simply the perfect platform to say thank you and goodbye.
So it's away we go then. Hoists it forward. Promising cross. Defending of the desperate variety. No, that's not the ball he wanted. Bonaventura. It's Pastore. And here's Lucas Perez. Bonaventura. And the counter is on. De Silva. Has a hit! And that certainly packs a punch. Bonaventura. And here's Bonaventura. Beautifully done. Regardless of the outcome, it is good to see someone running at the defence like that. Spreads it towards the left. It's come loose. Get a throw in.
The keeper deserves some sympathy there. He may not have seen that until too late.
Mm-hmm.
So we have our breakthrough.
Well, that's the currency he deals in, and he's come good yet again. Never the one to let you down in these situations.
Brown. He's through the middle.
Da Silva!
And the ball's come loose. Oh, real danger here.
But I have to condemn the defending. They've got to stop the cross.
Bonaventura, Vidal, it's Raul Gossip, and here's Lucas Perez. Valero, Vidal, and here's Raul Garcia. Flank.
There's a lot of movement going on. There's no shortage of options.
So I guess they're looking to play around their opponents as opposed to through them.
Yeah, the style is designed to dominate the ball, and so you dominate your opponents.
Albiol has to get it forward quickly. Kuchel. Forward it goes. Kelvin.
Just very well played. He can't hurt you with his back to goal, and he didn't go for the back heel.
Looking cross-field, changing the point of attack. He's looking to get there first. Valero. Run from a defender. Defending of the desperate variety. He could be in here. It's wrestled off the ball. Pastore. Out to the left it goes. Three. Demonstrating fabulous determination. He just will not be beaten. That will be the final action of the first half. So there you have it, a close-fought half of football, but Everton still had its moments, and ultimately produced just one goal. And more than decent game up to now.
Not the most convincing of displays, they could certainly do much better. Simple, build up their confidence and not rush into mistakes.
Here we go again.
The old boys
didn't have a great first half. They need a change of fortune. And it's Kolarov. Valero. Pastore. It's a loose ball. Promising run he's making on the right. Oh, Rilch has a hit! He scored! They have pulled themselves right back into it! Lovely goal, perfect poise to set himself for the strike. with some activity down on the touchline. It seems there's going to be a change. And that has added a whole new complexion to the game.
Well, look, Peter, who knows what's about to happen from here? I doubt this will be the final score, though.
Kelvin. Shot goal! Just off target.
Well, that's confidence for you. Distance doesn't even bother him.
Bonaventura finds himself eased off the ball.
They're actually not getting too tight, which is interesting. It's probably cautionary. Don't dive in, try to pinch it or intercept so nobody can get in behind.
Well read, he sorted that out. Raul Garcia, Astura already in the game. Mertens. Creativity and adventure. Adriano with the clearance. That is terrific skill. Looks to drop one in. Going through,
gets up to head it! Goal! Luton! Into the lead once more!
Well, the cross was inch perfect, and the header unerring.
Well, as contact goes, that was tremendous, and it helped him to direct it exactly where he wanted into that net. I think when it comes to the area of the park, this fella is definitely no slouch.
So we have a breakthrough. Now, how will things develop from here?
Surprise, surprise. He just keeps on delivering, and listen, we all expect that.
And here it's Lucas Perez! Oh, that's a terrific save from the keeper.
Well, that was high-class goalkeeping there to back up his high-class wage.
De Silva. And he's shown him a clean pair of heels. De Silva! Everyone off their feet.
Oh, how close was that to going in? It only required the smallest of tweaks.
well positioned to make that interception.
Keep calm and carry on. That's the job in a nutshell now.
Ventura loses his balance and loses the ball.
Peter, they have to fight the onset of desperation and keep enough cool heads to still deliver.
To save themselves here.
Well, it's looking like too little too late, but they are giving it all they have.
Pearson
plays it forward. Gucci provides an outlet. Reacted well to the initial effort, but couldn't get it right out of the danger area.
But for me, that's just pure credit to Brilliance. It's not so much the finish, but the way he read the situation, and nobody else was even alert to it. It's fantastic.
Boys have turned to their bench and we're going to have a substitution.
Well, he's worked so hard for his side, as you would expect, but he couldn't help notice that he was starting to labour a bit, so it's no surprise.
Luton would not have picked a better time to snatch a two-goal lead. Is there still time for a response?
Yeah, looks very much like the final nail in the coffin for me, I have to say.
Out on the left now. Get the better of his opposite number. Lucas Perez gets it back. And it shows there will be three extra minutes. Cashel. Added time is up, and there goes the whistle. Oh, this hurts. The pain of defeat, very evident. And there are hard lessons to be learnt from it all when they regroup. Could you summarise what we've seen today then, Jim?
Inevitable in terms of the result, but that doesn't tell an accurate tale. This was much closer than it should have been. It really dug deep.
Thanks to Jim alongside me. And as the fans make their way home, so must we. Good evening to you.